Hi everyone, this is JCRP and you're watching Kalakar.in. In this video, I'm going to answer a question that I get most often in this channel, and that is how to configure a new CNC. This CNC is called as CBeam CNC and it's from OpenBills. Although I got it from a Chinese maker and it's a hardware kit, which means the stepper motors, the electronics don't come along with this kit. So in the past couple of weeks, I did a lot of research to understand what is the best electronics to use and how to configure them. And I thought I will share those thoughts with you in this video. Let's take a look at the materials that are required. A stepper motor. This is NEMA 23 stepper motor and it takes about 3 amperes and it has an angle rotation of 1.8 degree, which is the usual that is required. These values are necessary in this project, which I will explain it to you later. The next is, by the way, they need 3 of this. The next that we require is this stepper motor driver. This is TB6600. I will have all the materials that I've used in the description, so please check that out. This stepper motor driver is available in different sizes, different shapes and different connectors, but mostly all perform the same. What you have to look for is what is the requirement of your stepper motor and what is provided by the stepper motor driver. So if it is, says 3 amperes, then you would need a stepper motor driver that can at least deliver about 5 amperes, and this one actually delivers 5 amperes. Also, there are different switches over here, and then there is a tabular column which understands what those switches do. For example, the first 3 switches actually control the micro stepping, and the last 3 switches control the amperes delivered by the stepper motor driver. In this case, I want only about 3 amperes, so I will set off on off, so that gives around 3 to 3.2 amperes. Anything more than that will actually heat up the stepper motors, so make sure that you set the switches properly. And for the micro stepping, make sure that all the steppers are set to the same micro stepping. In my case, I set them to 16 micro stepping. You can set it to 32 also, or just 1 also, by just switching, turning on and off the switches. Make sure that all the switches are set properly, because this is very, very important. The third one that you require will be an Arduino Nano, and even an Arduino Micro will be enough, but an Arduino Nano is perfect for this because you have header pins, you can change them whenever you want. And finally, a power supply. A good power supply is always good, and the more is the better. For example, this one is 12 volt 20 amperes. Let's do the math. The stepper motors require around 3 amperes of power, and then there will be some LEDs if you want, and the Arduino Nano. So this is actually an overkill. Even a 10 ampere or a 15 ampere power supply will be enough. But this is what I had, and this is what I will be using. So now that the materials are gathered, let's go ahead and take a look at the circuit diagram. So this is the schematic diagram of the CNC controller. We have 3 stepper motor drivers and 3 stepper motors, 1 Arduino and a power supply. To begin with, we have to ground all the instruments together. So I take the V- from the power supply and run it to the ground terminal, or the ground pin of the Arduino, and then go to the stepper motor drivers. So here's the ground pin of all the stepper motors, so I run the ground to everything. The second one is the V+ from the power supply, so that goes to the VCC of the stepper motor drivers. Now that is done, we have to take care of the other terminals over here. In our situation, we do not need the enable pins, so I'm just going to eliminate that. The stepper motor drivers have B-, B+, A- and A+, and these are colored differently, and then they just connect directly to the stepper motor drivers. To know which one is B-, B+, and the 4 different wires, check the description for the video. But for now, once you deduct the wires, they just connect directly to the stepper motor driver. For the direction minus and pulse minus, we take the same ground wire which connects to the ground pin of the stepper motor driver and connect it to them. So here you can see it's direction minus and pulse minus. The same wire that connects to the ground, I've just connected over here. The same goes for all the stepper motor drivers, which leaves us with just the pulse plus and direction plus. So for the x-axis, we will take pin number 2 and it will connect to the pulse plus, and the pin number 5 will connect it to the direction plus. Similarly, for Y we will be using 3 and 6, and for the Z we will be using 4 and 7. In the schematic diagram, I want to clear out one thing, that the power and the ground are the only ones which are parallelly connected. Other than that, all the other wires are individually connected, they do not overlap or are not parallelly connected. The schematic diagram will be actually available for download in the description, so please check that out. You can download it and print it. Now let's build the box. I am going to follow the staggered format because it will be easy to plug in the wire and screw it in place. At the same time, I have these status LEDs which can be actually seen from the top of the box. The box will have a glass top for this purpose. The wood that I will be using for this box is 8mm waterproof MDF. The box is put together using wood glue and brad nails. This was surprisingly plenty strong for this purpose. All the glue squeeze out was removed once the box dried out. I am going to build this step kind of design in which I can secure each of the stepper motor drivers, but it's kind of silly, so I will not show it here. For the front panel, I made the cutouts for switches before gluing that into place. You can see that I have chamfered the edges so that they sit flush to the edge of the box, and again brad nails to hold it in place. For the connectors at the back side, I have 3D printed this cover. I can draw the outer line and cut off the MDF. This way, even though the cutout is bad, the cover plate will make it look good. After giving a thorough sanding, I can spray paint it in black color. Then I can put in the emergency switch and other components required on the cutouts. I bought these 4-pin holders so that I can attach the motors in a modular way. In the front, to keep the air flow, I made a cutout and mounted a couple of 40mm fans. And here is the final look with the fan and the switches mounted. And the backplate goes like this. Once all the wiring is done according to the schematic diagram, I can close the backplate. By the way, the 2-pin plug is for the router. Now the stepper motor driver and the Arduino can be placed inside the box. A 4mm sheet of clear acrylic will cover the top. It is secured with screws. Now we can upload the gerbil to the Arduino. I've connected the wire to the PC and here is the website. All the links that I'm going to show you here will be in the description, so please check that out. So I go to GitHub, gerbil, and download it as a zip. I've already downloaded it, gerbil master. Let me unzip that. And once I go inside this, you can see the gerbil folder. Let me copy that, go to the user, documents, Arduino libraries, and paste it. I've already pasted it here. Once you have pasted it, you have to restart Arduino. So let me close that. Start Arduino again. Once that is started, you can go to File, Examples, Gerbil, and Gerbil Upload. And that will present you with the screen. Make sure that you go to Tools, select what is your board. In my case, it's Arduino Uno, this one. And the port, this one. Now I can push this inside it. Once that is pushed, we have to go to the Universal G-Code Center. The latest is 1.0.9 as of this video. Let's unzip the Universal G-Code Center as well. So let's try to open that. Once the application opens, this is how the interface is to be presented to you. Here you will select the port, and of course the baud rate will be the last one. So if you refresh and then say open, wait for it, and you should see the gerbil 0.9 and the dollar sign for help. This is very important that you actually see this message, and only then the connection is established properly. Now we can go to settings, firmware settings, gerbil, and if you scroll down, there are this $100, $101 and $102. These three values have to be entered. There is a calculator, easy calculator for it. Let me show you that. Here is the RepRap calculator. If you scroll down, you should be able to see the stepper motor calculators. So I'm going to use a lead screw. So my motor gives 1.8 degrees, which I showed you earlier, and it's almost 1/16th micro stepping. And my lead screw pitch is 2.0. You should definitely check what is the pitch of the lead screw that you use. Mostly the lead screw that comes for the 3D printers or the other is 2. So I'll do that, and metric is M8. So gear to gear ratio, there's nothing because it's just connected directly. So here you will see that we have to set the result as 1600 as the step. You can start with 1600 and try to move. For me, the best value was X, Y and Z as 400. There are different ways to get the step number, but I followed a method and that's what I'm going to explain it to you. On this router, I have set a bit which is around 1.5 mm thick, and then there is the scale. The scale comes along with this combination square, so it is very precise. So I've set it along and I set the router point to the first digit of the inch. Now let me zoom in. You can see that the router is set to the beginning of the scale and it's almost at zero. So when I'm pressing X plus, it's going to move an inch. And it moves an inch. It's perfect, it's almost perfect, but just to check it, I will move it to another inch and see if it works right. So it should again move to number 2, and that sounds right. And in this system, I've used lead screw on the Z axis, the X axis and the Y axis. So I know the value 400 works, so I'm going to enter that into the system. Once you're okay with all the values, click save and close. And at the end, it should save all the values and give you an okay as the confirmation. Once that is done, you are ready to get started. Now we can go to the easel site. I'll sign through it. So if you come to easel, you should see the button in green color, which means that easel has automatically connected the machine. Now when we click on car, you can see all the different materials and everything that can be used with the machine, and you can actually move it. So here also there is inches, there's one, and I can move in the X direction, I can move in the Y direction, and I can move in the Z direction. So with that, configuring the CNC and the software part is done. Now that the connection and everything has been explained, I just want to tell few things that I've done to the machine. The emergency stop. This has been linked directly to the power supply, so that if I press this, then the power just goes off and everything stops. This is really required when you're working with a CNC, because if something goes wrong, then this is required. And I can just turn it and it resets it. The second thing is, there is a router switch I have given over here, but that has been linked to the main power switch. For example, I have to start the main power and only then I will be able to start the router. If the power button is not on, I cannot switch on the router, which is another safety mechanism. With routers and CNC, all this safety mechanism is required, so I thought I'll let you know. If you have any questions or any doubt about this project, about the CNC controller, please put them in the comments. Also, I will make sure that there is a detailed write-up of this CNC controller in the description, so please read them if you have any questions. Please follow me on Instagram to see what I'm working on right now. I am Jesse Happy, and you've been watching Kalakar.in. Until next time, happy learning!